Hey, welcome friends. In this video, I will be discussing about the Simon-Smith reaction. This is a very important name reaction, and one question generally comes from this topic in any competitive exams. Okay, now one update about me is that nowadays I am a little bit busy, and I will be busy around 4th of May because my end semester is going on, and also I have to submit my project report, so that work is also going. So that's why I'm a little busy and I'm not able to making videos. But after 4th May, I'll be free and I'll make more videos for you. So now let's go to our today's topic. So Simon-Smith reaction is generally categorized as a reaction of carbene, but the reaction doesn't involve the real carbene. Actually, it involves the carbenoid intermediate. Okay, so what is Simon-Smith reaction? Let us take a very simple example. Let's say you have this alkene and you want to make a cyclopropane ring here. That is a cyclopropanation reaction. This is basically a cyclopropanation reaction, and for this it is used CH2I2, that is diiodomethane and zinc copper couple. So if you treat this any alkene like this with this particular reagent, zinc copper, actually this is zinc copper couple, and that is the alloy. Zinc copper couple is the alloy of zinc and copper, and this diiodomethane, you will get this cyclopropanation at this double bond. Now what is the mechanism of the reaction? So I already told that it involves a carbenoid reagent or intermediate, you can say. So this is your dimethyl iodide, and when it react with zinc, the zinc undergo an insertion reaction in this CI bond. So what you will get first is this zinc I. So you can see this zinc undergoes a insertion reaction in this CI bond to form this. Now either this particular reagent, that is this metalloid or this carbenoid compound, can act as your reagent, or another molecule of CH2I2 can again undergo an insertion reaction to give you this compound. So either this can be your reactive intermediate or reactive reagent in this case, or this, both are in the reaction medium and both can be the reactive part in this reaction. Now how I can represent the reaction? So I can represent the reaction like this. So here you have this iodine. I am taking this particular case, and here you have your zinc, and here another iodine. Now you can represent this by X also. This X represent either this iodine or this entire group. Okay, so representation of X is a general representation. Now you can see your alkene can attack here, and this I can go here, and now this C metal bond, this carbon metal bond, can go here. So this is the whole mechanism. In this case, your alkene, this alkene pi orbital, this pi orbital, it acts as homo. Okay, so always whenever you are writing a reaction, always try to find out what is homo and what is lumo, because every organic reaction involves homo and lumo. So this is the homo of, this is the homo of the alkene, and the lumo is this bond, this you can say this Ci sigma star bond. This is the lumo. Okay, so first this homo attacks on this lumo, then what happens, this I goes to the zinc, and this Ci bond breaks and it returns back here. So now you can draw the transition state also. So your transition state will look like this. Here you have iodine. So you can see the which bonds are breaking and which are forming, you can show in a single state. That is all the events, this breaking of this pi bond, making of this sigma bonds and breaking of this another sigma bond and the formation of this sigma bond and for breaking of this sigma bond. All the events are taking place at the same time. So this is a concerted reaction, and you can see a true carbene is never generated in this reaction. But again, at the end of the reaction, a CH2 unit, this is nothing but a CH2 unit. So this is a carbene equivalent. So at the end of the reaction, you are adding a carbene equivalent, but a free carbene is never generated in the reaction medium. So this is the reaction mechanism. Now, several selectivities, stereo selectivity and regio selectivity is obtained in the Simon-Smith reaction. So first I will talk about the regio selectivity. So regio selectivity means, let's say you have two double bonds. So this is your compound, you have two double bonds. This is more substituted one and this is less substituted one. And here you can have, again you can have OR group or maybe OTMS group, or you may have simple substitution. But these two double bonds should be distinguishable. That is, one is more substituted and one is less substituted. And when you react your Simon-Smith reaction condition, that is CH2I2 and zinc copper couple with this particular starting material, where you have two possibility, only the more substituted double bond will undergo the cyclopropanation reaction. Okay, so this is one example. You can have other examples, like let's say here you have OR group and here you have this, and the same reaction condition you apply, you will get this. Okay, so this. Now, why the more substituted double bond is undergoing the reaction, you can easily predict, because I already told you that the reaction occurs from the homo of the alkene. That is, in this case, the alkene is nucleophile. You can say the alkene is nucleophile and this is electrophile. Now, if you make the alkene more substituted, the nucleophilicity is increased. In other words, you can say the energy of homo is increased. And if the energy of homo increases, that means its reactivity will increase. So this double bond is more reactive than this. So this is why the more substituted double bond will undergo the cyclopropanation reaction. And the next thing I will talk about is the stereoselectivity. Now the stereoselectivity is very straightforward. Let's say you have an OH group here, and you are doing the Simon-Smith reaction with CH2I2 and zinc copper couple. So the reaction will always take place on the same side where your OH group is. That is, this OH group, it is in the above phase. So the cyclopropanation is occurring from the above phase. This is because while the reaction is occurring, you can represent like this. So this OH, and I told you that here this is your I and this is your zinc and another I. So this zinc is actually coordinated with this oxygen lone pair. So the oxygen has lone pair, so zinc has a coordination here, and that's why the CH2 group will be transferred from, so actually I should write like this. So your CH2 group will be transferred from the phase where your OH group is, and this reaction is faster than normal where you have no OH group there. This is because this chelation makes the reaction faster, because it initially binds the reagent with the molecule. That is, the molecule is more, possibility of attack on this double bond is more in this case, because it is already bind in this molecule. So whenever you have chelation in your molecule, the reaction is automatically faster. And the last example which I am going to discuss is very interesting example. So let's say you have a compound like this, where you have these two double bonds, and here you have this group OO. So you can see the stereochemistry of these two centers are different. That is, in here the OH group is below the plane, and here the O group, oxygen group, is below the plane, and here the oxygen group is above the plane. And if you do the Simon-Smith reaction, that is zinc copper couple and CH2I2 with this, what you will get is a very remarkable reaction, and it is a very important reaction for synthesis. So you will be getting this rod. So in this case, the reaction is occurring from the above phase, okay, and in this case the reaction is occurring from the below phase. So you can see, due to the presence of the oxygen, so this oxygen lone pair will bind with the zinc, and that's why in this case the CH2 equivalent will be delivered from the below phase where the oxygen is, and in this case oxygen is above phase, so it will be delivered from the above phase. So this is a very important example. So these are the important examples of the Simon-Smith reaction and their regio and stereoselectivity. So I hope you like the video, and if you like the video, then share it with your friends and give thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.